I want to show you very quickly how to use Amazon Elastic IP addresses to stop your IP address from changing all the time. This is obviously working for your Amazon EC2 instances, and if you have worked with them for a little while, you have probably noticed that every time you stop and start your instance, it has a chance of getting a brand new IP address, which is kind of annoying when you're trying to do stuff, when you're trying to connect to it. So let's pop over to the console and let's look at our instance and see what we've got. So I can look at my instance ID, and here I've got my public IPv4 address of 54.234.170.205. If I stop my instance, remember that 54 starts with 54, ends with 205. I'm gonna stop my instance, give that just a minute to stop, and it's stopping. And now my instance has stopped. So at this point, my instance is not costing me any money necessarily because it's not running, but it's sitting there unused. And if I refresh the page, it still says that's my IP address. Let's start the instance and see what we get. And now our instance has started again. So let's look. Remember, it started with 54 before. Now it starts with 44. The IP address has completely changed. The way that I access this machine from my local machine is going to be completely different because now I need a new address. If I have other things assigned like DNS records, that address is going to change, causing me problems. So what do we do about that? We are going to use an Elastic IP address. So what are we going to do about that? We are going to rent ourselves an Elastic IP address. Elastic IPs are a way to rent an IP address from Amazon separately from your instance and continue to pay for that IP address. Now, the way pricing works for Elastic IPs, if it is attached to an instance that is running, it is free. One IP address for an instance that is running is free. If your instance is not running, it costs 0.5 cents per hour, which means if we pull up the calculator here, $0.005 times 24 hours in a day times 30 days in a month means we're paying roughly $3.60 a month to rent this IP address if it's not being used, which would include times when your environment is shut down and all of your instances are stopped, you're going to be charged. But again, that's a total of $3.60 a month for as long as you're using this. So we can easily use one single Elastic IP address without causing ourselves problems getting into that $100 of free credit that we have. So let's pop over here. I'm going to scroll down on the left, looking on the left, right down in this network and security tab, click on Elastic IPs. And you'll see I don't have any at the moment. I'm going to first allocate an Elastic IP. That is me saying, hey, Amazon, I would like to rent an Elastic IP. We're going to just take it from Amazon's pool of IPv4 addresses. I don't need any tags associated with it. Those are just for organization purposes. So I'm going to hit allocate. Look, boom, I have a public IP address. It's 52.2.238.161. Now, what am I going to do with that? I need to take that address and I need to assign it to something. And hopefully, Amazon right at the top has given me this big box to say, associate this Elastic IP address. I can also do the same thing through this actions menu if that top thing is not open. Associating means you're taking an Elastic IP and you're tying it to an instance, giving that Elastic IP to an instance. You can release it to bring it back into your pool of available public IPs, but we'll worry just about associating right now. So I'm going to click on that associate button, choose an instance. I'm going to look at, and if I click here on this choose an instance button, it shows me my list of instances. I only have one at the moment, so I'm going to do that. I don't need to worry about which private IP address to use. And we can allow this address to be reassociated if we want to. That doesn't really matter so much right now for our case. If we need to reassociate it, we can reassociate it. But I'm just going to leave that unchecked because I'm going to leave it attached to that one instance. Now, I get the message that my address 52.2.238.161 has been attached to my instance. So now if I pull this up, I can click on my instance ID, and that address is the public IPv4 address. So if I stop the instance and then go back to the list and start the instance again and start the instance again, you can see that the public IP addresses stayed the same. 52.2.238.161 has stayed exactly the same. And that means I can save my SSH command. Let me make that a little bit bigger. And, forgot to add the username there. Yes, save that, and I am connected with that IP address. And now, when I stop my environment and restart it up again, that IP address is going to stay the same, so I don't need to go in and figure out what my IP address is, or if I stop my instance and restart it, I've got that IP address forever for the low price of $3.60 a month, or roughly $15 over the course of the entire semester, which is easy peasy. So that is how you assign an Elastic IP address to an EC2 instance, allowing you to keep the same IP address through restarts so that you don't have to keep remembering or looking up what the IP address is.